Item number one is discussion with ARC regarding Forsyth County's participation in water supply providers group. Mr. Tim?
Yes, thanks, Mr. Chairman. Today, Ms. Katherine Zitsch, who is the Natural Resources Division Manager with the Atlanta Regional Commission, asked to come talk to the board about a group that has been in existence for a long time. I'm not going to go into details. I'll let her talk a little bit about the group. I've known of its existence for a long time. Occasionally, they would invite me down to listen in when they were involved in the Tri-State Water Wars litigation. Their biggest role, in my opinion, in the last few years was assisting the state in the in water wars, and they were engaged as an active party in the lawsuit. Most of the other members are members in the Atlanta Regional Commission. Gainesville, however, is also in the North Georgia Mountains Planning District. Gainesville's also been a party and a member of this group for a long time. When we were at meetings, it was a little bit concerning that we weren't at the table when they're negotiating water deals with Florida and Alabama for the Atlanta area. We were not at the table. Sometimes I was allowed to stay in the room. Sometimes they'd make me get up and go outside. I've been told by one of my counterparts that at one time when discussions were real close to a settlement, we weren't part of the settlement discussions because we weren't at the table. And Gainesville has told me that one of the best things they ever did was join the group. So there's a cost to it. The board considered it a few years ago. Like I said, they do a lot of study work. It could be as a group. They may study everything from the effects of rule changes on the temperature standards to the river to phosphorus levels, whatever else may need to be analyzed and studied. They've done things like that. And those are the types of meetings that they allowed me to attend. I was not allowed to attend anything that dealt with the litigation. But obviously, I think, you know, we're becoming a bigger player as far as water utilities in the state. Fast approaching, you know, to be one of the top. There's not that many systems, really, more customers than us. So anyway, Katherine wanted to come back and talk to the board a little bit about the group and ask for consideration to join. I don't really expect you to have an answer today, but this is jumping off point in the discussion, and then we can circle back from there. Ken's aware of this group, and had some discussions because in the past they have been involved around litigation, yeah, but this is an open session type discussion. They're not involved in any litigation right now. So with that, I'll let Katherine talk a little bit about the group.
First of all, I want to thank you for having me here today. As Tim mentioned, my name is Katherine Zitsch. I'm with the Atlanta Regional Commission, and since the 1980s, we've collected this group of water managers across really the Chattahoochee Lake Lanier systems. The water managers include City of Atlanta, Fulton County, Dekalb County, Cobb-Marietta Water Authority, Gwinnett County, and as Tim mentioned, the City of Gainesville. And since the 80s, this group has been collectively funding both legal support and technical support to help with the water wars issues that have gone on for decades. Most recently, as part of the 11th Circuit Court ruling where Metro Atlanta got our water back, the group helped fund that effort, fund some of the arguments in the litigation through that process. Today, what we're working on is the Florida versus Georgia Supreme Court lawsuit. We're discussing this with the state and making sure that we're providing input as that process moves forward. We're also looking at water control plan updates with the Corps. We interact with the Corps very often. In fact, right now we're working on a data request with them to make sure that they get what they need for Metro Atlanta. In U.S. Congress, we've been working heavily on the Water Resources Reform and Development Act, which is moving through. You may have seen the news articles recently about Port of Savannah. Also in that act, there used to be language that was directly attacking our ability to pull water from our lakes, and we were heavily involved in a coalition building exercise to address that issue. Water supply rules, and then there's also an ACF stakeholders group that deals with from Florida, Alabama, and Georgia, many issues, and trying to build together a coalition to help address the issues from a stakeholder perspective, and we're providing input into that. What I would say for Forsyth County is, as Tim mentioned, there's a lot of education and input that goes in from being a part of the group. So become a part of the dialogue. It was before my time. I've been at ARC for about 14 months. Before my time that the some of the settlement was going on in which Forsyth was not going to have a seat at that table. So being a part of the group helps make sure that your interests are looked after. The group, in fact, does fund a lot of the technical work that comes out of the state of Georgia, and we work closely with the state of Georgia on water wars issues. So to be a part of that dialogue moving forward, I think, would be important to Forsyth County. As I mentioned, we have good relationships with the state and all the major players, and can help represent that. And that's really the big picture. Entertain any questions you might have. Or I can talk for 20 more minutes and upset all that.
Catherine didn't say it, but in my opinion, and some others, the recent success that Georgia had in the tri-state water wars, a lot of that came from on the backs of the study work and some of the work that the people they hired that were actively engaged in that. My opinion is I'm not sure the state would have been successful in the last round had they not been engaged, and it takes a lot of money. We've been able to sit back and kind of ride on the coattails of some of the bigger systems and the bigger users to help fund this, and it's probably time for us to get engaged.
What is the cost of it to us? Is it based on population, water users, or what's it based on?
It's based on the system size.
Yes.
The cost to the major systems would be much higher than the cost to Forsyth County. Are you looking for me to answer a specific question now?
Well, I'm sure we get some ranges, but it's based on water usage, I guess. Or customer base, I guess.
We would expect that Forsyth and Gainesville would be coming in at about the same level. And Gainesville is currently at $200,000.
Is that a year?
Yes, sir.
Wow. Is it appropriate to ask a question about the cost, Cam?
It is. It's going to depend upon the comfort level that the ARC representative has in responding to it. But yes, any question you all have is appropriate, of course.
Tim, would this $200,000 come out of water and sewer department?
I feel comfortable that it would, right, Dave?
That's a great idea.
Tim, are there any specific things that you're aware of that their organization got or talked about that we either would not have liked or we would have liked to have seen differently if we were a member of this organization?
I think we were fortunate in the some of the numbers that were put out there. I don't know what the settlement that was close to being offered to Florida and Alabama looked like as far as limiting water withdrawals from the lake, from the river, from who's going to get the expanded water withdrawal permits and who's not, so I really can't speak to that. That was always a concern that the governor's office was going to go down and try to settle the water lawsuits and put some caps in certain areas and us not be engaged. That was one of the hints I got from one of our neighbors that was a real risk because we weren't at the table in some of those discussions. I think it turned out okay. I just know that they funded a lot of the study work to talk about the environmental impact that really had on the mussels and the oysters and the sturgeons and to counter some of the things coming out of Apalachicola and the other places. You have to have scientific data and backup, and they funded a lot of studies and research to help provide that, not through their own attorneys, but to the state's attorneys also. As we know right now, we're in a wait and see if where the next step in the court case goes. But I think what's the status?
Right now, the Supreme Court just ruled that they're going to have the U.S. Solicitor General weigh in. We expect that to take 6 to 8 months. So sometime in the fall of 2014, the Supreme Court would rule whether they're going to take the case or reject the case.
Let me ask you one more question.
In Florida's in fact, in Florida's suit, they specifically named as one of the suits was against the state of Georgia and the water, Metro Atlanta water users, and named Forsyth County. Its water use as one of in the suit. We were named in the suit as one of the people being part of the Metro Atlanta's water.
Well, the Metro, does the cities belong to a separate, they belong like Atlanta or
Gainesville?
Gainesville belongs to Hall County, does it?
Gainesville does all Hall County's water.
I know, but I mean, but Hall County's, do they have a water system, myself?
They consolidated.
They gave it back to Gainesville, didn't they?
They did, but they're still, Hall County is moving forward with Glade without Gainesville at this point. So they're still, it's officially merged, but there's still some separate actions going on that involve water.
How about the city coming along?
They could. It's not limiting them. I think the ARC has reached out to the bigger water users that get their water from the Chattahoochee. You might notice Cherokee County is not in there. It's because their water comes out of the Etowah, and they've mostly focused on the effects from the Chattahoochee and Lake Lanier.
I spoke to Trish Barmeyer after this was on the agenda. It's been on the agenda some time ago, and one of the things that just was concerning to me, just because I didn't understand it, was if, I know this group gets together and discusses strategy and discusses what's in the best interest of advancing the agenda of the respective stakeholders, but what happens when there's actually court filings? I didn't understand that, because an unaffiliated group really can't make a court filing. And what Patricia told me is that once they sort of develop a plan, then they come back to the actual governments upon whose behalf they want to submit documents, and they will seek your permission, whether it's in a resolution or a motion, for this action to be taken on your behalf. In other words, you're not going to find yourself in the bottom of a V somewhere and don't know how in the world you got there because you hadn't signed off on anything. That was important to me, that you would have one more sort of bite at the apple before anything's filed on behalf of the county.
But this $200,000 a year wouldn't turn into, well, we've got another $100,000 or additional monies that you need to bring forward?
All I anticipate is $200,000 a year.
Yeah, and I had that discussion, and she's correct. I mean, that's they try to set a budget based upon historical experience. Candidly, I mean, there's a lot of folks contributing, so that should get you quite a bit of participation. If, however, the litigation really heated up, I suspect a couple of things would happen. Probably there would be, Tim would come back to you and say, look, all of the groups are being asked to put in another draw to further fund ongoing litigation efforts. And I think that it wouldn't happen without you knowing about it, and it's probably a situation where you would say, you know what, we're good.
We're totally dependent upon the lake. I mean, as our water source.
Totally dependent on the Chattahoochee.
Yep. And I think you probably want somebody there looking after our interests at all times.
At all times.
Well, yeah. So what's the thing to ask for, a resolution or further study or approval or a budget payment or?
I don't know, Tim. I mean, do you all view this as time sensitive, such that we need to approve something today? My preference would be a resolution authorizing the contribution, a resolution, just a little bit of explanation of what we're doing and why, and bring it back to you at another work session, and ultimately go on a consent agenda. Because you're authorizing a pretty good chunk of money, I think there needs to be a little support outlining why we're doing it.
Wouldn't that have to go through the Water and Sewer Authority first, or just come straight to us?
Straight to you. Okay.
Once this water wars thing is settled, if and when it is, I mean, is this something that we could reevaluate then and say, do we want to remain in it, or is there benefit to remain
able to back out anytime?
I think the way it stands now with the water providers that are in it, most of them provided funding for approximately a 3-year period that has carried us through 5 recently. That's not necessarily, I wouldn't want to set that expectation moving forward. And then when we need more funding, we go to each of them, and at that point the discussion happens all over again.
Right.
So it's not a one time and you're in it for life kind of situation. It's more every time that
some of the systems participate in this group and fund their own legal involvement in the actual case on top of this group.
So you're looking like a three-year commitment. What you're looking for is a year at a time.
I think it's more like, I don't mean to answer, but again, having spoken with Patricia, I think it's more like we pay an opt-in fee, and it gets us as long as the collective has the money to get us. So it may be 2, maybe 3 years.
Well, it's not every year, $200,000. It's just
I didn't take that away at all from my conversation with that.
Well, I would expect, because of the funding situation, Forsyth would be paying an equivalent to some of the larger funders. They paid a one-time, much larger fee. I would expect Forsyth to be more on the $200,000 annually. We're currently expecting the current amount of funds to run us through some point in 2015.
So we would be looked at every year.
Unless you want to pay the higher amount one time.
What's the higher amount, 400?
I'm not going to, I would prefer not to answer
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
Wait, more than that.
Let's talk. Is there any, y'all, are we interested, like Jim said, doing a resolution or can you write a resolution to look at this?
I have a bunch of choice.
That goes directly to Ken.
Would you want our, and I assume that the group anticipates a representative from the county to be at these stakeholder meetings? Would that be Mr. Perkins? Is that who you'd want me to draft the resolution? I mean, I assume that. I just
well, sure. We have to name, just say head of the water and sewer.
Well, right.
Yes.
Or a designee. Or a designee in case he's not available. Okay. You don't want to have to deal with that mess.
Okay.
Now, does that give Tim Perkins some more job security that way?
As long as you got the designation.
Yeah.
Council, how's that?
Mr. Chairman, I'm good because you're going to have to vote in the resolution. I don't need official action. I think I've got your direction. I'll bring you back a resolution. You can take official action then.
Is there any other questions for Catherine from the board since she made a long trip up here?
Thank you.
Is this something we need to do quickly?
Yeah, well, I said we'll attend the vote.
Can't bring it back to us.
I'll have it to you at the next work session.
Yeah.
Okay. We've been planning to do this since the snowstorms of January.
She's been on the agenda both snowstorms.
Well, she's had two snowstorms.
I told her if it snowed today, don't come back. Yeah.
Thank you all for your time.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
On to item 2, discussion regarding the development potential of 33-acre parcel.
As presented by staff.
Second.
It's all the consent.
I'm going to go home and look
for it. We have a motion and second for approval item 10. Any other questions? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. That's right. That's what we're looking for. Item 11, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, at the last work session, you heard a presentation from Katherine Zitsch, with the Natural Resources Division Manager for ARC regarding the county participating in what we're calling a water supply providers group. It's sort of an informal association, representatives and stakeholders of multiple water providers, including the City of Atlanta, Fulton County, Dekalb County, Cobb-Marietta, Gwinnett County, and the City of Gainesville. And their primary function is to basically assemble and review with council the status of all the various water issues that are implicating Georgia and their ability and availability of water resources. They work with council, they design either expert reports or technical studies to assist in litigation effort, and if in fact they get the right recommendation, they may bring a recommendation back to the body that sent them, like a county or a city government, and ask that they be able to litigate if that is in fact advances their interests. Although we have had some involvement with these groups, we've never had any so-called skin in the game. And I think now the county has decided, based upon just where we are and all of the activities that continue to arise around water, that we ought to go ahead and financially contribute, as well as have a dedicated member that is actually an active participant in this supply providers group. So what I have prepared is a resolution that would authorize that to have the water and sewer director or their designee be the actual representative of the county at the stakeholders group, and we would pay $200,000 which would be a share of the cost for all of the legal resources and things that they do with this group for at least a year. ARC has reviewed the resolution we put together. They're comfortable with it, and I think this is exactly what the board directed they do at the last work session.
Isn't that right, Counselor?
What's that now?
It's a one-time fee unless the legal fees.
Nothing stops them from being able to come back and ask for it.
Oh, yeah, they can come back. The way I structured this is $200,000 gets us a seat at the table for at least a calendar year. After that, it may get us more than that, but if they have a heavy litigation effort or a lot of expenses, they may come back in 13 months.
But we have the ability to opt out of it.
At any time.
At any time.
And candidly, I think one of the things that staff was concerned about is that we have sort of leveraged off of this group for a while, and maybe it's time for us to contribute just a little bit toward it.
It's coming out of water and sewer funds, correct?
That I do not know, Mr. Chairman.
I think it is.
Yeah. And when Tim was here before, he said he thought we should do it.
He did.
He's all for it. This is time sensitive item to council.
It's not time of year.
It's not designed, as far as I understand, it's not time sensitive.
I'm sorry, I skipped down to 12. It's not time sensitive.
Tim, did you say it was for calendar year?
I'd like to make a motion.
I did.
I don't think it is. It's a year.
Adopt the resolution.
Will ensure membership for one calendar year from the other payment.
From that point.
From that payment. So calendar year.
Adopt the resolution authorizing contributions to the former stakeholders group, the water supply providers group, protecting and preserving existing future water supply and for other purposes as discussed here this afternoon with a one-time membership of $200,000.
Motion second.
For the final.
Yeah. Just a minute. Are we all right, Counselor?
You are perfect.
Now, the motion was a one-time membership of $200,000. That's our, is that should be a one-time membership or just a, as Mr. Bob stated, or just a yearly?
My preference would be, and forgive me, I was.
I know y'all
would be just to approve the resolution as drafted.
Would you take
a restate?
Take back a second.
Take back.
I would like to make a motion that we approve the resolution authorizing contribution to the informal stakeholders group, the water supply providers group, as it exists in our books.
Perfect.
Second.
A motion and second for approval item 11, resolution as presented. Any other questions? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0. Ken, you can't be sleeping down there. Had to catch you on that one.
So, I was interfering with him, I'm sorry.
That's fine.
He has 2 ears. He can listen to one.
He didn't know what district that was in.
He's listening. Item 12, county attorney. Can you handle this one?
I'm not sure, Mr. Chairman. Let me try.